Hey everybody, welcome back. Today's discussion is about the Gopicnic brand salami and cheese ready-to-eat meal. If you watched my previous video on this, we did the turkey stick and crunch, and you can find that in my list of other videos. So we're going to open this up, look at the contents, try it out, and discuss. Well, I'm going to discuss. You can leave comments. Open on the side. Easily peel the top. Here are the contents. Now this package, compared to the first one I did, this is 3.6 ounces, or 103 grams of food, so a little bit more product inside. 410 calories, 12 grams of protein, and 2 grams of fiber. And it's also no artificial colors or flavors. And it's about the most important stuff on the stuff here. We've got an expiry date for this one of June 2016, a little bit longer lived than the first one I did. I'll take a still shot of the nutritionals and put that in at the end, as I do usually. So we've got it all unwrapped and ready to go. We start with the salami beef slices, spreadable Asiago cheese, and flatbed crackers, olive oil and sea salt flavored. There we are, nice peelable lid. I took that off camera to save you all some time. And then we've got what I think is possibly the world's smallest salami. No jokes, please. That's about an inch or so across. There's your inch and a bit cracker. And your spreadable cheese. I haven't touched this yet with a cracker, but I want to see how soft it is. That's not bad. I was expecting a bit of crackage. You see there's a bit of oil on the side here. It's probably separation just for time. This packaging is still good for just over 3 months from the date of the video being taken. So we should be good to go. I'm going to try these all three. First, I'm going to try the salami. A little bit of greasy. Doesn't smell overly strong. Actually lacking a bit of flavor, kind of boring. More of a ham sausage than a salami. I'm gonna try the cheese and the cracker here. I'll try the cheese first. Interesting texture. It doesn't become fluid or very soft in the mouth. It almost crumbles apart when you taste that. Flavor-wise, it's a medium-strength cheese. It's not a really strong aged cheese. But it does have some good cheese flavor. The cracker, I'm gonna try one plain first. Yep, that's nice. Crunchy, a little bit of a doughy taste to it like a cracker should. And I'm not getting much of a hint of olive oil or sea salt off of that by itself. No. All right, let's make a little sandwich here. Wild and take three whole slices because I only have a few crackers, and down the hatch. As a combo, acceptable, very nice. Alright, so that's the end of the salami, crackers, and cheese, and I just wanted to show you this cheese. This is like some of those wine bottles. You see it on the top, it looked like it was quite full. When you look in the bottom, you see that dimple down here? That takes up some of your volume, so it's a bigger looking container. It's got a wider spread on it, so it looks like there's more there, but they've actually put that dimple in to reduce the amount of volume of product contained in there. So it was pretty good. Volume of food, it's still somewhat a little light. So we're going to go to the cashew medley, which is, it's like cashews, white chocolate, chips, more of the craisins. I believe they're cranberry raisins, actual raisins here, and that's about it. I'll give that a handful, randomly, pop it in their choppers and see what happens. Oh, tastes as it should. It does taste like white chocolate, so it is. Cashews are cashews. And the two raisins and craisins are both of a decent consistency, not overly dried out, not overly sugary. And now the last item on this one is the chocolate wafer bites. These are filled chocolate little cookies. You can see there is quite a bit of crumble action in there, so they did get beat up in transit. I'll try a couple of those. A perfectly tasty delight. A little bit of soft chocolate in the center. Nice crunchy shell. A cookie of sorts. There you go. Pretty tasty. I'm going to finish those up. So I will say, as I do in all my videos, thank you for watching. If you did enjoy the video or the content, please like, share, and subscribe in the usual places. And join me on Instagram. I do pictures pretty much every day on there of something that entertains me or has caught my fancy. Again, thanks very much for watching. We'll see you on the next one.